In the process of document typesetting, using the break feature correctly can help us effectively improve the readability and aesthetics of the document. We can use different types of break in different situations. Here we can use this paper to demonstrate the various usages of the break feature. 1. Page break. If we want to place the content of the Level 2 heading on a new page, we can insert a page break. Click the beginning of the Level 2 heading, click the Breaks drop-down button in the Page Layout tab, and select Page Break. Or we can use the shortcut key Ctrl-Enter to insert a page break quickly. 2. Column break. We mainly use column breaks when editing a paragraph that is split into columns. Take the first paragraph of the document as an example. We have already split the paragraph content into two columns. If we want to use the former mainly includes as the beginning of the second column, we can add a column break here. Click where we want to split the column, then click the column break in breaks. 3. Text wrapping break. We usually use the Enter key to do line break. If we just want to wrap text, but don't want to create a new paragraph, we should use the text wrapping break feature. Take this paragraph as an example. Click the position where we want to wrap, then click text wrapping break in breaks. Or we can use the shortcut key Shift-Enter. We can also see a downward arrow at the end of the previous line. This is the mark of line break. 4. Next page section break. When the article needs to be divided into chapters, we can insert section breaks. The advantage of inserting a section break is that we can use the chapter navigation function. After clicking the section navigation pane button in the section tab, we can quickly preview in the left pane. Take the second Level 3 heading as an example. Click the place where we need to do a section break, then click the Next Page Section Break in Breaks. Then we can do a page break. 5. Continues Section Break. If we only want to do section break and don't want to do page break, we can insert the Continues Section Break. Take the content of the Level 2 heading as an example. Click the place where we want to split, then click Continue Section Break in Breaks. After inserting a continuous section break, the format of the original text will not be changed, but we can see the changes of the chapters in the chapter navigation bar. 6. Even page section break and odd page section break. Even page section break and odd page section break are mostly applied for special needs in layout. Let's use the odd page section break to demonstrate here. The usage of this function is very simple. For example, when we add an odd page section break at Elective Experience of Tourism Culture on page 7, the following paragraph will jump to the new odd page, that is, page 9. The same is true for even page section break. After insertion, the paragraph will start from the next even page. This is all about section break. Let's learn it together.